What's up, guys? Master Riggs here, bringing you another live duel. Today, I'm playing my Masios versus my good friend Edgardo's Draco Pals. So yeah, heroes versus the meta. Let's see how it goes. I won the dice roll, so of course I chose to go first. And I opened up pretty decent. So yeah, I had some Summoner Monk, pitched the Soul Charge. I had a Mass Change in hand, I believe, and I was contemplating pitching a Mass Change, but I decided to pitch Soul Charge, because Soul Charge is good for the opening boards, that's why I play it. But I just decided to have the second Mass Change so I could do a double Dark Law Banish on his turn. So yeah, I grabbed my Mass Change, you know, or I forgot, but I grabbed it. Edgardo was nice enough to remind me that I forgot to grab it. So yeah, and I go ahead and set two. I believe I had like a warning, a Mass Change, and I can't remember the last one, but as you can see, I was pretty set. Or no, two Mass Change and like a Solemn, I believe. And I decided to special the Bubble Man in case I chose to go for an acid play. So standby, go Dark Law, bring out Dark Law effect, search. I search out another Bubble Man. I could have gone Alias, but I chose Bubble Man just to have the Exceed play in case I do like a Summoner Monk or something. So yeah. But Alias is really good as well. And sorry guys, I just had some chips with like fucking Tapatio and shit. And he upstarts. And this may have been a bad play, but I chose to do Dark Law's effect to banish. Because I was like, ah, fuck it. You know, I have another Mass Change to search. And I ended up hitting Wavering Eyes, which he really needed. Because he had Ariadne in hand. So, yeah. Pretty nice. So he does Draco Face Off. And I believe I end up giving him Luster. And yeah, I gave him Luster. But yeah, guys, I still think Masios are really good. It's just Cosmos is a tough matchup, and Monarchs can be a tough matchup as well. And here, Edgardo is considering a play to do. He can't quite decide, because if he synchros, everything's going to get banished. If he exceeds, whatever he detaches is going to get banished. So he's really at an impasse here. And he decides to do a move that blew me away that I did not see coming. He went into Castell, but he chose a different Castell effect. He chose to Book of Moon my Dark Law, which is pretty strange, but he really didn't want Luster Pendulum banished. And here he sets his two scales, and I decided to acid him. And at this point, I don't really care that I'm going to give him a Solemn Search, because I clearly have the advantage on board, and he has nothing. Well, he has one card in hand. And he's going to have a trap set, so I figure, you know, I don't give a fuck if you get your Solemn. So I go ahead and acid. And thanks to that acid, his Castell lost 300 points, so he couldn't beat over my Dark Law and Death. And he sets two and passes. And I drew a Dark Bribe, and as you see, I have the clear presence of the board here. So I just attack over Castell. And everything's banished. And I hit him with acid, and I just set my Dark Bribe and pass. So I'm pretty in control of game one. He draws an MST, and he's just scoops because he couldn't do shit. So game two, he opts to go first, of course, and he keeps telling me he opens up ass. You know, he's like, "Oh, dude, I opened up ass," which is a complete load of shit because he opened up fucking stupid. So yeah, he pops a Rodne, gets a search, and I just give him the strike because I feel like strike isn't as bad. Strike can't stop my Mass Changes or my Hero Lives. So, yeah. And from here, he goes upstart, gives me 1,000. And, yeah, he does painful decision. Then he goes ahead and summons out that Vector. Free summon, pretty much. I think, right? Yeah. And he sets his scale, and he pendulum summons. And he's here. He's just contemplating his move, what to do, because obviously he's gonna put up a fat ass board, and he pendulum summons four. He has a pendulum sorcerer. He has an Ariadne. He pops the Ariadne and his Luster, and he gets to search another counter trap. And you know, and he gets to search two more cards, so he just goes insanely plus. He has Gee Turtle And yeah, it was just stupid from here. And then, you know, I'm choosing a counter trap. Then, you know, he had his Skull Crib at Joker as well. So it's stupid. And he goes ahead and exceeds for Paladin. Paladin effect special. Then he goes into an Ignister specials and from deck, and he's going off from here. And I'm thinking to myself, how the fuck am I gonna get over this? And I don't remember if I do. I guess we'll find out. And then Dinosaur effect. I believe he activates it. And then he goes to Scales, Ghee Turtle, Lizard Draw, draws. Draws again, just pluses. He does all this and ends up with three or four cards in hand. Look at that. Look. He just starts showing off from here. So yeah, he's just doing more shenanigans, and he goes into another Dinosaur, and he specials again, and bam. And then just add insult to injury. I believe he goes into Harbinger, where he chooses not to. I think he forgot, honestly. I believe he forgot to go into Harbinger. So, sucks for him. And my opening hand was pretty decent. If I would have gone first, I think I could have won, but sadly, you know, didn't work out. So I said everything because I think I'm going for a Bubble Man play here. And it's not the most optimal play at this point, but I really have nothing else. I'm too terrified of his giant board, and I know he has a few Solemns set. So at this point, I'm kind of lost for words of what to do. And I think the Chaos Trap pulled my Shadow Mist, and from there, I just set, pass. I didn't expect the Chaos Trapple, and he apparently mains it, and that shocked the shit out of me. So, I really did not see that coming. I should have, but that card's really good this format. And at this point, I'm losing. I know I'm gonna lose, so he activates Eccentric, and I tell him, you know, fuck you, I'll lose my way. And yeah, guys, I think for me, I pretty much scoop. So, I mean, he clearly has a board advantage. I mean, it's really whoever goes first. I told him, wait, chain my Ekol, chain my Rota, and I win. And he chained his monkey board and everything else. So, yeah, I pretty much got wrecked this game, guys. So we're going into game three. And let's see what happens, game three. Because I don't remember who wins. I think I won, though. Just scarily by the, just barely by the skin of my foreskin. So, you know, I'm shuffling up. You know, I decided to go first, of course. And I think I opened up pretty decent, you know. Hero lives, I guess. Pay half my life points effect. Search out my mass change. Pretty standard opening. And I decide to mass change, I believe, and go into my Dark Loss so I can have an instant fusion play. I hope Norton doesn't go, guys. Norton is such a great card. So I, you know, mass change. Going on my Dank Law. And then, yep, Insta Fusion Norden, grab Shadow Mist, going to a Raphosia. And I go from here. So, you know, I XYZ. And I don't remember what back row. I believe I opened up a Solemn as well. So I set two and passed. I had a Solemn and something else. I can't recall what it was. I'm sorry about that. But yeah, at this point, he can't, you know, go through Dark Law. So he decides to normal summon. I forget the name of that bitch, but he was gonna tribute it to pop my Dark Law, and I wasn't having that, so I just warninged it. And at this point, I'm at 1,000 life points, so I'm pretty fucked here. So I mean, literally, he just has to push for the slightest bit of damage, and I'm done. And this is where I start to get worried. But I feel like in Heroes, life points don't really matter that much, because if you can set up your opening board, it's a tough board to crack. For any deck, even like Draco Pals or something like Cosmos, although Cosmos could break through Heroes pretty easily because they don't care about Dark Law too much. But against a lot of other decks, Heroes just kind of stall them out, and you really only need to get through one turn, and you can OTK in the next turn or deplete enough hand or deplete enough resources to where they can't beat you, and you can beat them. So yeah, that's kind of the whole point. This deck can grind, obviously. But even with Hero Lives, the life point cost can be high, but Dark Law is such a good card that you just need to bring him out. And here, I believe he goes for Raphaelsia. And apparently, I didn't know, but this guy doesn't even play Bottomless Trap. He doesn't play any holes whatsoever. He just went into Raphaelsia to psych me out. He had just forgotten to take Raphaelsia out of the extra deck because he knew I couldn't beat over Raphaelsia. So I just left it like that. And from here, I think a lot of the game is just kind of like pass, pass, pass turn, pass turn. The game really slows down. This is by far, I think, the longest duel we had, which was game three. So yeah, he goes for his Pendulum Sorcerer. Wait, how? No, I don't even remember anymore. We were dueling like at 3 in the morning. I don't know how you summoned that. I think he might have normaled it. I think I fucked up and let him normal summoned again. So that's on me. I don't know how he brought him out, but oh well. And he brings out a Raphaelsia of his own. So now I'm scared shitless of Raphaelsia because I don't want to get bottomless or time space. But little did I know that that guy didn't even play that, and I top deck the MST and get rid of one strike, and I just pass because I can't do anything. I'm at 1,000 life points. So as you see there, I drew the instant fusion, which I can't even use, which is a fucking shame. And I don't know what he top decked, but his hand is full of scales from what I can see, and he can't really bring anything else out because everything else is banished. So he normal summons a Skullcrobat Joker. And I let the effect go through. And here he searches something out, probably Monkey Board. And at this point, I can't quite decide whether I should do Dark Law's effect because I'm afraid that he's trying to bait it out with a strike. And if my Dark Law goes, I'm kind of fucked. But I say, fuck it, YOLO. And I believe I go for Dark Law's effect. Yep, and I hit. So he didn't have the strike, thankfully. And I hit Luster. Ouch. And then he says it's Guillotirtle. He goes to draw. I say that's fine. I don't know what he drew. Then he goes Monkey Board. Search. Some bullshit. Bring Shadows back. At this point, I mean, we're both really, we're both in the grind game. We can't do much. We're both stuck. Me, because I was afraid of Raphaelsia, and him because I had depleted already a lot of his resources thanks to Dark Law. So we were both just kind of grinding it out, hoping we would top deck something. Then he goes to Pendulum Summon a few cards. And then I go effect Raphaelsia. And I believe I bottomless him. I try to dump Regeki. If only that would have worked. I mean, isn't that how Raphaelsia works? Now you dump Regeki? Or so I thought. But what a dump. I dump bottomless, so I got rid of like one or two cards, I believe. It wasn't the best, but it was better than letting him bring out all those because then Lizard Draw, I believe, is a level 3, so he couldn't really do much with his board at this point. So yeah, I think he just passes. He has one set, and I'm afraid that's some kind of solemn. So like I said, this is a really slow duel. The Raphaelsia, it's so scary. It's such a target, man. Like you never really know what's gonna come out of it. It could be a bluff. They could already have everything set, so a treacherous would be awful or something like that. You never know. And then on the end of his turn, I go ahead and Shadow Mist effect search, and the pluses start coming, and he didn't have anything to stop it, so I knew that one card was not a strike or he would have used it. And I go ahead and draw for turn, and what do I top deck? I don't remember. Bam. So let's see what's going on here. Goblinburg effect. I'm trying to bait out his stuff, and oh wait, no, I did no effect. Went into an XYZ, and like I said, I was trying to bait out back row here, so I went into a Castell, I believe, and I activated Castell's effect to get rid of that bitch. And apparently, it went through. I was shocked as hell, guys. And then Shadow Mist's effect activated, so I added the Bubble Man. Shuffle up, and I'm really in the driver's seat right now. So I mean, I got my board. I got four cards or three cards set, one in hand, which is a Bubble Man. So I just decided to beat over everything. So attack Dark Law, banish, attack with Dark Law, banish. So this guy, as you can see, he's starting to stack up a big pile of banish cards. And on his end phase, he goes ahead and does Wavering Eyes, I think. Which he knew was a stupid play, but at this point he was desperate for anything. And he banished two cards. And then he has one card in hand, and he's going to have another card. So I decided, you know, Dark Law Effect. And I still thought he was trying to bait something out. But I guess he didn't have anything, really. So he goes Eccentric and activate Dark Law's effect. Or no, he takes it back and he searches something else out. Damn, dude, I feel like getting my ass ate, no lie. Like, have you guys, like, ever had your ass ate? Dude, not just playing, nah, that stuff's gay. Nah, hey, on a real. I love you, Edgardo, thank you for dueling with me, you're my friend. So I activate Dark Law's effect, and let's see what I hit. Ooh, I hit out the card he searched, man. Talk about a luck sack. And he activates Unexpected Die. And I don't know why I check. I mean, it's not like I can Solomon. I'm at like 1,000 life points, I think. Or he might have upstarted me. So I'm at 1,500, but I forget. Oh, there it is. Upstart right there. And I was actually at 500 life points because he Wavering Eyes on my end phase. So he kept me safe. And activate Dark Law's effect. And what do I hit? Ouch. Oh, man. He sets. And I draw for turn. And I just kind of... I mean, this is game here, really. Let's see. So, yeah. I dropped Gaga Samurai because I was trying to bait out some back row. And I still got my effect with Mist. Searched it out. Got another Bubble Man. And this is pretty much it from here. So, thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed this duel, please let me know in the comments if you enjoyed this commentary more than music. And I appreciate you guys for watching. Thank you very much. And I'll have some more duels for you guys coming soon. So, thank you guys. And thank you, Edgardo, for dueling with me. And I ended up winning, for anyone who's wondering or lost track. I got the match 2-1, Heroes versus Draco Pals. So, thank you guys for watching. And stay tuned for some more content. Like I said, now that I have a tripod, I have a lot of content coming your way, a lot of duels. So I hope you guys enjoyed this, and thank you very much, guys. I appreciate it.